Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton, and you have found a YouTube channel solely dedicated to all things WordPress. So last week we talked about what would it look like if you inherited a website or had to work on a website that you did not build out. How do you find kind of putting your ducks in a row? How do you find the different areas that you need to be editing? How do you make sure that it's secure? How do you make sure that it's up to date and that everything's correct? What do I do? So that's the video from last week. I'll put that in the description box below so you can catch up on that. But this week, I really want to look at, okay, once I have that, now how do I go in and make other changes? So be sure to watch both videos because I'm going to give you pointers kind of in different areas. This specific one is about how to get to areas maybe inside of your theme or inside of your website that you're just not really sure where anything is. So check this out. I'm going to show you a couple of spots that you might not think to check. So let's look. This also depends fully upon what theme you're using, right? This is a custom theme that we have going on, but I want to show you a few areas that you can still look for things. On the front side of a website, you know, if you're looking at a sidebar and you're trying to figure out, okay, where does something live if it's in the sidebar area over here, either right or left? Or maybe you're trying to find something down in your footer area and you're trying to figure out, okay, how do I get into these things so that I can change these areas? So those areas are called widgets. It's a fun little word. And those live inside appearance and widgets. So again, depending upon how your theme was built, we've got four columns in our footer, and this is footer widget 1, footer widget 2, footer widget 3, and 4. And you can see that all of these are custom menus. So really, when you open them up, there's nothing to edit per se, but at least we've found out that living in that column is this specific navigation menu. And we know then that we can go over to the menus area and go find that menu and make edits to that menu. So pretty cool there. Different things you can do to get in and make changes to all these different areas. And again, it really just depends. So you might have an area where you go into customize to go edit your theme. Or you might have an area called theme options that you're able to get into and go make changes to your specific homepage. And also be aware that you might have different tab areas across the top that you need to access. You might actually have, depending again upon your theme, an area that says your theme name even. Let me scroll here, your theme name even. And that might open up an area. This particular theme would be the Divi theme. So that might open up an area for you to dive into and make some edits and customizations. All right. So best case scenario, jump into the support documents or the documentation inside of your theme folder. If you unzip that, you can find some really good goodies inside of there that'll give you some clear directions, hopefully, from your author. And if worst case scenario, you need to really find something that's buried deep, you can plug in a plugin called What the File. I'll put a link to that and another video that we have that'll walk you through exactly how to use it. So I hope this helps you, and I hope y'all have a great WordPress Wednesday. Bye, y'all.